डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, थर्ड सेमेस्टर, सब्जेक्ट CGM, सब्जेक्ट कोड 22318। मायसेल्फ मिस अनिता शिरतुरा, वी आर फ्रॉम देवी महालक्ष्मी पॉलिटेक्निक। चैप्टर 1, राष्ट्र। लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस वीडियो, लाइन ड्राइंग एल्गोरिथम। In this line drawing algorithm, the Bresnahan's algorithms are explained in this video. Now, previous video, I have told about the line drawing algorithms type, the DDA algorithms as well as the Bresnahan's algorithm. But I will explain in this video in briefly. So that's why this remaining. Bresnahan's line generation algorithm. There is one more algorithm to generate the lines, which is called as the Bresnahan's line algorithm. The distance between the actual line and the nearest grid location is called error, and it is denoted by G. When we are selecting the upper pixels line, and if slope is less than 0.5, then we are selecting the next line. Suppose the slope of line after dips being first point as 0.0, and we will add the slope of line to error factor G, so that G will become 0.4. We are considering gentle slope. Case we are moving along x-axis, so next pixels will be x is equal to 1, and at that time y will be decided by G. Then how it is possible? So
students, let's continue with the Bresnahan's line algorithm. So in the previous video, I just given an introduction part of the Bresnahan's line algorithm. So I said it is an efficient method that used to perform the line operations very rapidly and very quickly. The lines can be generated quickly. Okay, so here we are not using the incremental approach like DDA. Here this method is use the next pixel that is selected based on the least distance between the true line. So I already explained what is the decision parameter. Based on the decision parameter, it's a greater than 0 or less than or equal to 0, you are going to take TI or SI. Okay, now let's see the algorithm. Step 1, first let's start accept the start and end points. You need to accept the start and end points, that is the x1 comma y1 and end points are x2 comma y2. And step 2 is finding the decision parameter. So if you find the decision parameter value, then it is easy to find which value you need to be taken, which value is the closest value to the true line. So how you are going to calculate the decision parameter? The formula for this is di is equal to 2dy minus dx. So just remember this formula for calculating the decision parameter. Okay. So here dx is equal to, it's nothing but x2 minus x1, and dy is nothing but y2 minus y1. Okay. So this is the formula for, calculating the decision parameter. And next, step 3. So what is step 3? Suppose if di is the decision parameter is greater than 0, then what you have to do? You have to take di plus 1 is equal to di plus 2dy minus 2dx, and here xn is equal to, that is the x increment value is the next point, x increment value is equal to x1 plus 1, and y increment value is equal to y1 plus 1. So this is a y1 is the previous value, x1 is the previous value. So this has to be plotted on the graph. Plotted points. Step 4. Suppose if di is less than 0, if it is, let's take it is less than 0, then what I have to do? Di plus 1 is equal to di plus